February is right around the corner, so if you're sitting down to do your monthly planning for the month ahead, today's video is going to share some resources to help you make the most of your planning process. Hello, my charmed ones, and welcome back to my channel for another video. And if this is your first time with me, I would like to say welcome. My name is Alexis, but I'm also known as Miss Trenchcoat all across the internet. I'm an online entrepreneur who designs and sells digital productivity tools to help you work smarter, not harder. So if that sounds interesting to you, I'll leave some links down below in the description box where you can check out more of my work online. And feel free to download some of my latest free productivity tools over at thecharmedshop.com. So as this video goes live, it is the Sunday before the upcoming month of February 2018. And so today will be the day that I sit down to do my monthly review where I sit and plan out the overview for my month ahead. Now, in order to help me get organized and focused on what is going to be important for me for the month, I have a few different resources and processes that I go through that I wanted to share with each of you. Now, the first resource I have is a freebie that's up in my shop, which is my monthly dashboard. So every month I make a monthly dashboard, and it's actually like a double-sided dashboard that you can download and print. It's a PDF, and it comes with print instructions so that you know how to print it for whatever size your planner is, if it's A5 or half letter or full letter, or if it's FileFX personal size, there's directions for how to print it for your custom size. And so this is a two-page dashboard that I use in my planner that has the calendar month in the front. And then on the back, it has some really important monthly review items that I always incorporate into my monthly planning process. So the first thing that we've got up top is a mantra. So I like to choose either like a mantra or a quote or like an affirmation to help me kind of set the tone for my month. So it might be something that I'm thinking about, something that is important to me. Maybe it's something to help me overcome something I've been struggling with, but I will choose some sort of quote or mantra or affirmation, and I will put it in this section so that I kind of have it front and center, so I know that like this is what I'm focusing on this month. The next section here is the largest section in the middle where I will map out important dates. So when it comes to my monthly planning, I like to make sure I've mapped out any important like holidays. For example, Valentine's Day falls in February on the 14th, so I'll keep track of that. And any other important things I've got, like appointments or meetings that are actually scheduled on the calendar, any birthdays or any due dates for projects that are important, I like to just sort of outline them in this important date section. That kind of gives me like a one-page sort of snippet where I can just see like all the dates that are very important. It helps me locate information pretty quickly. Of course, this information will also be inside of my month on two pages view in my planner, but I like having it like a little snapshot on this dashboard. Now, the next thing that I will fill out is the monthly goals section. So I like to set for myself 3 monthly goals. So these will be like things that I've been working towards or things that I have scheduled to work on for this month or this quarter. And since I'm someone who already maps out their goals in the beginning of the year, I already have my goals mapped out. So really all I need to do is like fill in the goals, like transfer them from my project planning and goal tracking area of my planner to this dashboard. And then if I don't have all 3 filled up, I'll also like do extra goals. Like I'll make myself some extra like personal goals that might just be like fun things or just things that'll be like self-care or, you know, personal in nature. So I'll like kind of give myself my own little challenge, something else that I might want to look forward to. And then finally, I have an area to fill in for my reading list. I am someone who is an avid reader, or at least an avid audiobook listener. So I have a bunch of audiobooks that I have in my queue that I need to finish. So I'll be probably reading Captivate by Jessica Van Edwards, I think is her name. I'm also reading The Vortex by Esther and Jerry Hicks. So I will put these down and then I'll pick another book from my reading list and put that in here as well. So for me, this is pretty much like a one pager that gives me like a really good solid overview of what I'm working towards for my month. And then of course I can break down additional details later on in my planner as the weeks progress. But this is my monthly overview process, more or less. Now, when you download these free downloadable dashboards from my shop, you also get with it one of my monthly checklists. So for a few years now, I've been making these monthly checklists and they are themed for the month. So this month it is 28 ways to love yourself because February is the month of Valentine's Day. And for me, February is not just like a romantic month for like couples and like for you and your partner or like your husband, wife, like whatever. I think that it's also a great time to focus on self-care. And so this list has 28 different ideas for things that you could do during the month to express love to yourself and take care of yourself. So the idea with these is that I've got a list of 28 items, which means you could do one thing every day. So you could actually choose like to follow it in order, or you could just choose what you want to do on a daily basis. By no means is this anything really formal. I mean, this is just something that I like to do for myself to kind of keep track of ideas and, you know, glance at this every once in a while. So I keep this with my dashboard in my planner, and it's just something fun that gets me excited about the month and reminds me to take care of myself and work on personal and fun things as well as my business and my like life in general. That's normally the majority of my planner. So the third and final resource I have for you for planning your month ahead are the free tech wallpapers that are also available on my shop. So every month I design a new tech wallpaper that is themed to the month. So for this month, I have a design that says February, love yourself. And it's just something for you to keep on your phone or your tablet or your laptop because the files do come formatted for either smartphones, tablets, or desktop or laptop computers. So the idea is you use these tech wallpapers and they kind of keep you focused against something that pertains to the month. In my example here, it is, you know, self-love, loving yourself, self-care, which goes in nicely with the 28 ways to love yourself checklist. So if you're someone who could use that extra boost of inspiration on your gadgets, which tend to be the things that we always have the most or we're looking at the most, either like a phone screen or a computer screen, then I welcome you to go ahead and download those as well. And it's just another way to help you get focused on your month ahead and really help bring meaning and intention to your life. So those are the resources that I have for you for February. I am hoping you guys have a very successful and productive planning session for your month ahead. And I would love to know down in the comments what you're looking forward to for February. Is there a specific goal you're working towards? Maybe a book you're reading, an affirmation or mantra you're using, or is there a certain event like a birthday or a holiday like Valentine's Day that you're looking forward to? I would love to hear what you're looking forward to for the month ahead down in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and feel free to share it all over social media, wherever you think it would be helpful to share. Make sure you're following me on Instagram at Ms. Trenchcoat if you'd like more behind the scenes of my life and business. And of course, if you're not yet subscribed to my channel, what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button for more awesome videos by me. And until next time, bye-bye.